What's up, Sons? It's Blind Rod with Sonvitech once again, and today we're going to be going over benchmarks since the latest patch for Cyberpunk 2077, patch 1.04, along with basically testing all of these GPUs with the hex code edit enabled on the Ryzen 5 5600X. We have benchmarks for not only the 3070, but the 6800 as well as the RTX 3080 now, because we got that in. And there are some very interesting results. Basically, since this patch, what we are seeing are a lot of differences between the way these GPUs perform and where they're suited strongly and not suited strongly. And you're gonna see it, it's wild. But first, let's talk about the test bench. The test bench, as mentioned before, is the Ryzen 5 5600X. For this current benchmarking, we do have it overclocked to 4.8 gigahertz, and it is running on a water loop because we were trying to test the graphics cards here, so it's pushed as far as it can go. The other big note is we do have smart access memory enabled in this particular case, and that is going to be giving, of course, an advantage, which you will be able to see here, to the RX 6800, actually for a very specific reason in the case of Cyberpunk, which we'll be talking about as we go through it. And finally, it does have the hex code edit to the executable to enable the rest of the cores, which I did a video on. If you want to do it yourself, you can check out up here in the corner, we'll have it linked. And that brought our CPU usage from 40 to 50% to 70 to 80%, pretty much doubling it and increasing performance across the board on all GPUs. We're paired with 16 gigabytes currently of G-Skill Neo Trident Z, clocked at 3600 megahertz at 18 CAS latency. And we are running an NVMe drive, the Sabrent Rocket 500 gigabyte drive, NVMe drive, on this particular motherboard, running at the PCIe 4.0 speeds. And yeah, we have a whole bunch of benchmarks here, all the presets for every resolution or every standard 16:9 resolution. I don't currently have access to any ultra wide resolutions, and maybe we can get that figured out in the future. But without further ado, let's get into the charts. Okay, so we're gonna start off with 1080p low, which is gonna be the most surprising thing here. And the reason is because once we start looking at 1080p, we start relying on CPU performance, especially in Cyberpunk, who is very CPU bound, that pesky little Cyberpunk. That being said, what you'll see is basically the RX 6800 taking the lead thanks to smart access memory, because what smart access memory is doing is giving you a little bit more CPU power on the 5600 XT when working with, of course, a 6000 series GPU. And this is the biggest performance improvement thanks to smart access memory that I've seen across all of my testing, and is super impressive and is really something to keep an eye on here in the future with more CPU bound games. That does continue through 1080p medium, 1080p high, and 1080p ultra, where in all cases at 1080p, as you can see, the RX 6800 is beating out the RTX 3080. This is a non-XT 6800, and this is a big deal and something you guys should take note of. If your intention is to play this game at high FPS 1080p, then you really want to be looking at AMD graphics cards right now. That doesn't maintain true once we bump up to 1440p, where we do start seeing a slight lead for the RTX 3080 over the RX 6800, but it's a very slight lead on low settings for obvious reasons, because we're worried about that CPU keeping up there. And the lead starts to build up over time as we go through 1440p medium, 1440p ultra, and where with ultra we can clearly see that we have a performance lead for the 3080, and the 3070 starts to close the gap on the 6800. Finally, moving to 4K is where we start to see the big differences here between the 3080 and the 6800, where it takes a commanding lead with 4K low being able to have an average FPS of over 60 on the RTX 3080 and kind of going down from there as you would expect. That being said, it isn't a big enough performance increase to justify the increase of cost of the RTX 3080 at retail over the RX 6800. Now, the big news, of course, for the NVIDIA side of things is that you will have access to both ray tracing and DLSS. We have the presets here for ray tracing on both the 3070 and the 3080, and what it's going to provide you is an idea of basically both DLSS and ray trace performance between the 3070 and the 3080. And it is very, very playable, luckily, on the RTX 3080, at least at 1440p with your mins at on ray tracing medium on the 3080 being around 49.8. You don't notice as much, of course, at 1080p, a difference between the 3070 and the 3080 as much as you would expect, especially with Ray Tracing Ultra. And that's going to come down to, once again, that CPU performance. And that is really what the end of the story here is going to be. So, wrapping things up. What did we learn? We basically learned here that Cyberpunk 2077 is probably going to be, your upgrade path is probably going to be more beneficial to upgrade your CPU over upgrading your GPU. And the reasoning for that is that the game is very CPU bound. Thanks to Smart Access Memory, if you're looking at purchasing a new system, CPU bound games do seem to perform better, at least at lower resolutions or once you start requiring more interaction from the CPU. This is very common to see once you go lower and lower in resolution as the graphics card needs to communicate more quickly with the CPU. And it's very clear here to me that Smart Access Memory is going to be a game changer for CPU bound games. That being said, of course, if you want the ray tracing features and so on and so forth, then you want to clearly be looking at the 3000 series until, of course, we get ray tracing support, hopefully here in the near future for Cyberpunk on the Radeon GPUs, and then we'll be able to test and see how that all shakes out between Radeon and NVIDIA. The performance improvements for the RTX 3080 over the RX 6800 don't seem to justify the price increase, in my humble opinion, but you know, that's going to be left up to you. Either way, if you have either, you know, any of these cards, the 3070, the 3080, or the, of course, the RX 6800, I think you are going to have a playable experience, and it's going to be good. You're going to actually be able to play Cyberpunk, unlike a lot of people, so feel blessed as far as that goes. I do. A big note here is on those 0.1% lows. I did want to point out the RX 6800 currently is going to be the only GPU where you will stay above 60 frames per second at all times in any situation. Okay, so that includes DLSS, as we've talked about testing. And that's a pretty big deal. And the reason I believe it's able to stay above that 60 FPS at 1080p is thanks to Smart Access Memory. So if you want a all-time, always above 60 frames per second experience, you're going to want to have the latest 5000 series CPU from AMD and a 6000 series GPU from AMD and pair those together and get Smart Access Memory enabled. We will be testing the i9-10900K versus the Ryzen 5 5600X in Cyberpunk coming up here shortly. We got to get it on the test bench, and let me know in the comment section how many GPUs we want to test and all that. Do we need to go through all of the benchmarks again or not? I'll throw up any additional benchmarks that were not shown during this video now. I hope the video was helpful. Be sure to leave a like, comment, and subscribe down below, and I will see you next Tuesday.